号车开不跑路了。
Ladies and gentlemen, today we brought here half of the country of China's new energy vehicle, totally 50 pure electric vehicles, all waiting to be roasted at this high-speed circular test track. And curious how we picked out this car? All the tested models are new, launched within the past year, some even in a week.Like Li Xiang i8, Envo L90, and all-new MG4. The list covers all mainstream brands' popular EVs with one sedan and one SUV or MPV per brand to suit diverse buying needs. In short, you will find every major brand and hot EV in today's market at this 50-plus car summer range test.Then why bother to test 51 cars on the high-speed circular test track? From my 2 years of experience driving an electric vehicle myself and dozens of EVs tested by Autolab in the first half of this year, I've discovered three major problems. In summer, highway driving with AC often cut EVs range to 60%, a claimed 500 km may only hit 300 km.Fast charging is erratic too, advertised as 15 minutes for 20% to 80% and half an hour for a full charge, but it often takes an hour with long queues at service areas. What's the most annoying is still the AC. When driving at 24 degrees for 100 km, the range drops by 140 km. But that's not the worst of it.The key problem is that when the battery is low, the air conditioner stops working. Driving a car feels like being in a sauna. Who can stand this? And these are not isolated cases. Fans also ask which car actually has a real range and which one has the most reliable fast charging speed. And this time, we will use the most stupid method to reveal the truth. According to the consistent test standards of lab tests,For 51 vehicles, the test started with the battery level is uniformly at 90%. The vehicles run at a constant speed of 120 km per hour on the high-speed circular test track. The AC is set at 24 degrees with automatic wind speed, and the driving mode, kinetic energy recovery, and the chassis height are also set to standard of comfort.Only one driver with a weight between 70 to 80 kilograms is left in the vehicle. The tire pressure is adjusted according to the recommended value on the nameplate. Until the vehicle speed can no longer maintain 120 kilometers per hour, record the driving mileage and then directly go to the charging pole to start testing the charging speed.This high-speed track is at China's largest automotive testing ground, Guangde Test Ground, over 9 km long and designed for 280 km per hour. Renting it by an hour costs us 2 Xiaomi Y7s. Today's surface temperature is 40 degrees. High heat plus continuous high speed makes the harsher than highway driving with AC. Thus, the range here will be shorter than your daily theoretical range. Of the 51 cars,Some top range with full 900 volts, others says that using a 6C battery can achieve faster charging. Some also say that the 10-in-1 electric driving is most energy saving. Real strengths are just a hype. This report list will surely guide your car buying and usage decisions. So are you ready? This 2025 Summer New Energy Vehicles Range Final Exam of Autolab officially begins.After nearly 5 hours of testing, all models finished the range test. Let's first check the range achievement rate, RAR list, most relevant to the daily driving. This data shows the percentage on the officially claimed range actually achieved on highways. Even the best barely hit 70% of their market CLTC range. Most top half models are around 60%. In short, a 500 km CLTC range cars will go roughly 300 to 340 km at 120 km per hour on highways. Notably, models differ. Urban runabout are nearly all in the late second half. Even the top small cars, ID.3, barely reaches 60%. They are not bad, but their battery management system BMS suit low speed, short trips, and they feel accurate in cities. Yet on highways with AC usage and surging wind resistance, the BMS struggles. Top-ranking models are mostly MPVs and family SUVs and are designed for long road trips. These models were more optimized and celebrated for high-speed scenarios from the state of the R&D, so they performed better in our high-speed circular range test, where RAR shows the gap between claim and reality. Power consumption rankings better reflect a vehicle's three electric system strengths. At sustained high speeds, motor ran at high RPM with much higher load than in low-speed commuting, so motor efficiency directly impacts power use. Often compared at brand events, Tesla Model 3 and Model Y maintain the brand's edge in energy control, ranking top 3 with excellent power consumptions. The other top 3 finisher, Rav 6, was a mild surprise. Additionally, XPeng P7 Plus and Mona M03, Wuling Starlight and other ranked high, might have appeared in our previous lab test. Thought conditions were less strict, result trending similarly, verifying stable energy consumption control. And the mileage list is more straightforward. It shows how far a vehicle goes for 90% displayed charger until it cannot maintain 120 km per hour. When it cannot hit that speed, the battery is in protection mode. Power response slow, risking insufficient strength to avoid emergencies. Get off the highways nearby, don't push up. And another safety note, the top 30 cars on the list all have over 330 km rear range. Our peace of mind figure. In the factory, most drivers need to rest after 300 meters continuous driving, plus 10% buffer for vending chargers. And anything below this means stress on low trips. Of course, the test ranking are not meant to put down or press everyone. They aim to show there's no universal range, only what fits you. If you often drive long distance, focus on cars with high achievement rates and long actual ranges. For city commutes with occasionally highway trips, no need to fret. After all, knowing your car limits matter more than blending chassis long range. And finally, note that some models' range may be affected by options like large wheels, sport tires, or add luggage racks. Thus, these results are for reference only. Overall, we aim to offer a high-speed range reference to help plan long trips better. After testing the battery range, proceed with the next charging test immediately. In this phase, we uniformly use a 180 kW charging pile to charge the vehicle from 20% to 80%, which is also consistent standard of our lab test. The previous overall stringent extreme range test left many vehicles standard on the high-speed track, unable to reach the charging station. By the time rescue vehicles transport them there, both the power battery and the auxiliary battery were fully depleted, and many then could not be charged. For score statistics, we directly show you how much electricity each car can charge per minute. This data is more intuitive than how long it takes to charge a 90% battery. For example, when charging at same highway service area, some cars can run 120 km of 20 minutes of charging, but others only 70 km. The key difference lies exactly in this electricity intake per minute. Top-tier models can charge 2.6 to 2.9 kWh per minute, equivalent to approximately 12 to 18 km of range. Topping the list, Zeekr 7X delivers outstanding charging performance. During the test, its average charging capacity was 2.91 kWh per minute. It can charge 58.2 kWh in 20 minutes, already exceeding half of its battery capacity. just enough time to listen to 5 songs, and it will replenish most of the range for the rest of the trip. Models in the middle of the list also charge over 1.5 kWh per minute. Mine hits 179 kW, maxing out the charger's capacity. Testing with a 600 kW liquid-cooled supercharger would yield even better results. Like the range rank list, most models in the second half of the charging list are small cars. Due to the cost, their batteries are generally small, but charging takes 30 to 40 minutes at roughly 1 kWh per minute. Some A0 class models are even slower. These cars are aimed at different users, mainly for urban commuting, with batteries not well suited for super fast charging. Now the toughest test, AC cooling after sun exposure. This car just sauna'd in the sun, with interior temps heating nearly 60 degrees, most extreme than your summer open parking cases. Set to the lowest temperature, maximum fan speed, and active rapid cooling if available. Use auto circulation or internal if no auto, with front and rear AC on. Let's see which cools fastest. Sensors are placed at full headrest, front rear rows and left right sides, and one at the rear of the center armrest in the cabin. Totally 5 points. The average cooling level comprehensively reflects the car's cooling performance. Results are data-driven. Top performers saw an average temperature drop of over 20 degrees, bringing the cabin to a comfortable range. The new Firefly also impressed, as the smallest participant, with slightly lower AC compressor power and battery size than larger cars. Its average cooling range still reached 80.6 degrees, just shy of 20 degrees. However, several low-ranked cars had a weaker AC cooler, with an average drop of 16 to 17 degrees, insufficient for summer comfort within 10 minutes. In summary, if your car has a panoramic sunroof without a sunshade and you want to instant coolness in summer, turn on the remote cooling function at least 15 to 20 minutes before departure. 51 new energy vehicles are undergoing continuous high-speed circulatory tests at 120 km per hour. We will make the three most troublesome issues in summer: range, charging, and air conditioning crystal clear. Let me summarize some key points.
For range, the key is the achievement rate, not just the display. Battery types, weight, wind resistance all matter, with long rolling resistant tires boosting range most. For charger, 800-volt platform and high-rate battery are critical. These configurations significantly speed up charging vs ordinary cars, retaining advantages even in summer heat.
Of course, our test this time is only from one perspective. Some cars may have average range, but they have a large space and offer a comfortable ride. Some cars may have a slow charging speed, but they have a good sound insulation and the air conditioner cooling down quickly. Choosing a car is like finding a partner. There is no perfect one, only the one that suits you. Moreover, the progress of the new energy vehicles does not really rely on the parameters boasted by manufacturers, but rather on the real feedback from users. Regarding the data results of this actual test, apart from the video, we will also organize them into chart and release them. We hope to provide you with real and useful reference before buying a car. You can compare them before making a purchase. However, this test is not the end, but the beginning of the new chapter. Next time, we have prepared a series of big productions for you, including intelligent chassis test and extreme cold winter range test. Keep following Autolab. See you next time.